कृष्णवर्णं तिशाकृष्णं सांगोपांगास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः संकीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्तिः सुमेधसः अन्तःकृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादिवैभवम् कलौ संकीर्तनाद्यै स्मः कृष्णचैतन्यमाश्रिता जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रीलरूपसनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य विलिखद्ग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितम् पर्यालोच्याथ पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यः श्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोजा भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतद् अन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमन्मन्त्रदेशिकमीश्वरम् श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अथ नत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुं यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमेयातिश्चिन्मात्रसत्ता व्यंशो यस्यांशकैस्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यं स श्रीकृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम्
यू कैन ओपन युवर न्यू हैंड आउट इट्स अनुच्छेद 2 So in the last class we were discussing all other pramanas than the non-defective shabda. So other than the non-defective shabda, all they are dependent. They are rooted in so non-defective shabda only. This we did, this task, which is a major task actually. And pratyakshadi pramanas of the Laukika Purusha will not touch or cannot touch or never touch the alaukika vastu. Why? How can we say this? Pratyakshadi pramana safe laukika purusha. That means any purusha. Those will not touch or that means those we cannot give the knowledge about alaukika vastu or the achintya vastu. Yeah, yes, Samananda Gaur Prabhu, Mike.
Because of they have 4 defects, sir.
No, that's not the answer. Oh. Who wants to say? You want to say, yes.
Yeah, yesterday we discussed that with the example of a dog and a forest boy.
Yeah.
So the knowledge they receive only of material objects. And they have a pravritti and nivritti only. They do not get anything of shabda.
By the help of by the knowledge acquired by the pratyaksha anumana and so pramanas of laukika purusha. So that knowledge which is acquired from these pratyaksha and others pramanas, at maximum what it can do, that knowledge that will be developed in you, either attraction or the aversion towards some material objects, not more than that. Example is, if you take a boy, so if you leave him, if you leave him in a forest at the early age, so then what will happen at the very at young age, if he left in that forest, then can he develop any kind of, that means, knowledge about the absolute truth? He cannot. It's not possible. So the same way, even we have seen the animal example also. Animals also, they have the pratyakshadi pramanas. But by maximum, by using those knowledge of those pramanas, so what they are doing, they are maximum, they are eating and or otherwise, so they are hating. So that much only they can do. They cannot do more than that. They cannot know the by that knowledge about the absolute truth. Yes? That's not possible. Okay, this is clear. So based upon this animal and the boy who is grown up in forest, based upon that we are clearly saying that so this pratyakshadi pramanas are not going to touch the absolute truth. So they don't give any information about that. So some other small boys there who are in the family where the mother, father and teachers, they teach about the absolute truth, then he will learn actually. So that means in our whole life, we are knowing about the Krishna or we are knowing about the absolute truth. That is due to what? That is due to Shabda only. That is authentic Shabda only. If anyone is properly developing knowledge about the absolute truth, means that is happening because of the authentic Shabda Pramana only. So like this, we discussed, actually that we cannot, we didn't establish that, but we established that pratyakshadi pramanas of the Laukika Purusha are not going to give the knowledge about the absolute truth. This much we discussed actually. Now today, we are going to discuss how this non-defective Shabda is determined. So that means we have to now find out what is this non-defective Shabda. Till now, every day we are hearing non-defective Shabda, non-defective Shabda. What is that? What is that non-defective Shabda? Which can be that? So now come to the Anusheda number 10. Tatastani, Mula I am reading. Tatastani here, you see. Tatastani na pramana, pramanani. Pramanani ityanadi siddha sarva purusha paramparasu sarva laukika laukika gnana nidanatvad aprakruta vachana lakshano veda eva asmakam sarva atita sarvashraya sarva chintya ascharya swabhavam vastu vividishitam pramanam. What Jugoswami is saying in this sentence? Tataha tani na pramanani. Those are all not pramanas. What are those means what here? Tataha tani means those, na pramanani, they are not pramanas. Those are, what are those 10 pramanas of any laukika purusha? Okay, prana pramanani, na pramanani means why? That means they are not pramana, they cannot act pramana independently, they cannot act pramana always without any help of the non-defective Shabda. They cannot act as Pramana always. Sometimes they may act as Pramana, sometimes they act as Pramana Bhasa. So if they want to act always as Pramana, then what they need? They need the support of Shabda Pramana, non-defective Shabda. So that's why we are, and also they independently cannot touch the, or they cannot give the information, knowledge about the absolute, alaukik vastu. That is also, these two problems we showed in the last Anusheda, actually. We discussed very elaborately that. Now then, if those are all not the pramanas, that means those are all not useful for us to know about our anubandha chatushtaya. Our anubandha chatushtaya is Krishna, Sri Krishna. Next is Sri Krishna vachya vachaka sambandha. Next, bhakti abhideya prema prayojana. We want to know about all these. So to know about these things, or we want to elaborate all these four. We want to elaborate. And but Krishna is alaukik vastu. It is not laukik vastu. It is not available like the, so like how we are having this table, a laptop, this projector, they are all laukika. So like this, Krishna is available directly. Is not available directly. So that's alaukik vastu. He is beyond the material creation. He is. So then already we came to know that our 10 pramanas are not going to so useful those that, for that, because they have four defects, and also they are not able to give the any information about the absolute alaukika vastu. Okay. Then what is the hope? Then non-defective shabda is the hope. Then what is that non-defective shabda? Anadi siddha sarva purusha paramparasu. Anadi siddha. So it is from the beginningless. It is established already. Anadi siddha sarva purusha paramparasu sarva laukika alaukika jnana nidhanatvat. Aprakruta vachana lakshano veda eva asmakam. Sarva atita sarvashraya sarva achintya ascharya swabhavam vastu vividishtam pramanam veda eva pramanam. English, you come to the English. Thus sense perception and other means of knowledge cannot be used as pramana. So Vedas are only pramana for those who desire to know about an object which is beyond everything. That means sarvatita, which is shelter for everything, sarvashraya, and which has the nature of being inconceivable and astonishing to everyone. That means sarva achintya ascharya svabhavam. Because what are the reasons? These are the reasons. That whole sentence is divided like this. So in this sentence, we are saying Vedas are the pramana. We are saying Vedas are the pramana. Only Vedas are only pramana. These are the pramana for whom? For the those who desire to know about an object which is beyond everything. Sarvatita, sarvashtraya, sarva achintyascharya swabhavam vastu vividishatam. Ten pramanas gone. Now we take that non-defective shabda as Veda. Non-defective shabda is Veda. What he is saying, Vedas are the pramana. Vedas are pramana for whom? For whom? First, those for whom? Those who want to know about an object. An object beyond the everything. So how we are getting this? What is the Sanskrit for this? Sarvatita. So Vedas are pramana for whom? Those who want to know. Who want to know? Vividishatam. What is Sanskrit for this? Those who want to know means those who desire, otherwise, or desire, those who desire to know. Vividishatam means those who are desiring to know. Of what? Vastu. Object. Those who want to know or who desire to know.
who desire to know. What they are desiring to know? About an object. That is in Sanskrit what? Vastu. What kind of vastu that is? What kind of vastu that is? Sarvatita, sarvashraya, sarva achintya ascharya swabhavam. What kind of vastu that is? Sarvatita, sarvashraya, sarva achintya ascharya swabhavam. That means that vastu, that object is shelter for everything. That is shelter for everything. And also after that, that is the it is beyond everything. First of all is, it is beyond everything and it is shelter for everything. And also sarva achintya ascharya swabhavam. What kind of this swabhavam it is having? What kind of nature it is having that vastu? It is inconceivable and also it is astonishing to everyone. It's very wonderful and it is so magnanimous and so wonderful. So by knowing that, everyone will get some excitement. Oh, it's like that. It's not ordinary object. So this vastu is like this. Sarvatita, sarvashraya, sarvascharya, sarvachintya, ascharya swabhavam vastu. So those who desire to know this kind of vastu, for them Vedas are pramana. For them Vedas are the pramana. Why for them Vedas are pramana? He is giving reasons. Reasons he is giving. Why Vedas only pramanas? What is the reasons he is giving? One is, first one is anadi siddha sarva purusha paramparasu sarva laukika alaukika jnana nidanatvad. What is that? And aprakruta vachana lakshanaha. Its swarupa is non-material words or aprakruta vachana lakshana. Aprakruta vachana lakshana first. That means these Vedas are the nothing but the words. These words are not prakruta. Veda words are not prakruta. The words in the Vedas are not prakruta. Prakruta means those are not made by you and me. Like now we have the laptop, now we have the cable. These words are all we made it actually. But the words whatever there in the Vedas, that Varanas, that and words, those are all aprakruta, from the beginningless. So they are there. They are not made by anyone. Okay. Aprakruta vachana lakshanaha. Here aprakruta means what? It's not that the transcendental. You should not take every word of Veda is transcendental. No. Is it like that? Aprakruta means what you should take here? Not made by any man. Like that you should take. Okay, we'll discuss so many things about this. In the future, we are going to just after 2-3 classes, we'll be discussing. What is the difference between the Lord's name and these material names? So many. So those points will be coming anyway. So now first to take it as, now these Vedas are aprakruta words. Okay. Next, it gives knowledge of this material world and also beyond this material world. Sarva laukika alaukika jnana nidhanatvat. It is giving the knowledge of laukika. Laukika means knowledge related to the material objects. And alaukika, that means beyond the material objects, material world. Okay, this is second. Third one is it is accepted by all paramparas which are famous from time with no beginning. That means anadi siddha sarva paramparas. That means which are from beginningless, they are coming, the paramparas like the, so madhva sampradaya, like this is all sampradayas, Sri, so Kumara, Rudra, all the sampradayas which are coming from time immemorial, that is a beginningless, they are all what, they all accepted this. So that's why the Vedas are the pramana for the people who desire to know an object which is beyond everything, which is shelter for everything, and which is inconceivable. Vedas are the pramana. Okay, it's clear. So this is sufficient. Vedas are the pramana. So that's why non-defective shabda we should take as Veda. You are satisfied or not? Satisfied. Non-defective shabda is Veda. Okay, you are all satisfied, means then we don't need to study Sarva Samvadini. Then there is no need to study Sarva Samvadini. By the Moola itself, you are very much happy. Then there is no need to study Sarva Samvadini. So that means such a students are very satisfied. Why Vedas we are taking? That means all of Shrel now Vedas came. And yes, Vedas is the Pramana, and so is said, and they take, we took. So is it okay? No. Yeah. Okay. Now we will see. In Sarva Samvadini, come to the Sarva Samvadini. This is. Atha evam sabdasyeva pramanit. प्रमाणत्वे पर्यवसिते कोसौ शब्द इति विवेचनीयम् शब्दस्य एव प्रमाणत्वे पर्यवसिते को असौ शब्द इति विवेचनीयम् इफ यू कम टू द सर्वसंवाद डिस्कशन प्रीवियसली व्हाट वी अंडरस्टूड दिस 10 प्रमाणास आर नॉट यूजफुल एंड ओनली द नॉन डिफेक्टिव शब्द is the authentic, and it is a root, it is the shelter, and it is base for all other. So now then, what is that shabda? What do you mean by non-defective shabda? So non-defective shabda means what? Defectless shabda, what can be the defectless shabda? Whatever I know, that is non-defective shabda. Like this, everyone says, then what will happen? He will also say, whatever I know, that is non-defective. He will say, whatever I know, that is non-defective. And whatever I experience, that is non-defective. Like this, everyone can say or not. Yeah. Tatra brahmadi rahitam vachaha shabdaha iti aneneiva pariyaptir nasyat. Simply, non-defective shabda means the shabda which is free from the four defects. Brahma and all. Brahma and so. If you say simply it's free from these four defects, that shabda is non-defective. If this much, if you define like this, then is it sufficient? Is it sufficient? Why it is not sufficient? Then what will happen? This is not sufficient actually. Na pariyaptihi syat. Ityanena eva na pariyaptihi. That means it is not sufficient. Simply if you say non-defective shabda means which is free from the four defects. This much if you say, this kind of definition is not complete. It is not enough. It is not sufficient. Why? Yatha swa mati grihe grihite pakshe brahmadi rahito ayam. Eva iti pratiswam matabede nirnaya bhava patte. तथा तस्यापि शब्दस्य प्रत्यक्षावगम्यत्वेन परानुगतत्वात् अप्रामाण्यापत्तेः। What we are saying? We are saying that non-defective shabda means, which is free from four defects. If you define like this, this is not sufficient. So this definition is not sufficient. This definition is not sufficient. This definition is not sufficient. Reason. What is the reason then? Ashray Gauram Prabhu.
It says Brahmade dosha rahitam, but there is no connection with the. We want to know sarvateta, but this word says we are not seeing any evidence that this word is connected to that sarvateta or sarvasarya. No connection is not.
First of all, let's everyone make the tune with the class. Actually, I'm seeing some synchronization is needed now. Frequency matching is happening. Now synchronization has to be done. Like when you set the radio, you have to hear any channel, then you have to take that bar in the right place. So tuning is necessary. Similarly, what is happening? Where we are now? Tell me where we are. So online students, where are we? So who is going to tell? Ram Charan Prabhu, tell me. What is happening? What is this Tattva Sandarbha? Where we are? What we are studying? Why we are studying? What is this?
We are trying to find it out what is the this
mic khole ya nahi acha theek hai dusra ko dile take another one mahaseva prabhu is vikas dubey prabhu
hare krishna
vikas prabhu
hare krishna
so your connection is there or not yours
you can hear me prabhu Hare Krishna Prabhu, can you hear me?
Okay, on site le lenge. Okay, actually we have our own technical problem. That's why online students, we are not able to hear you. So okay. By that time, so at least are they able to hear me or not? Wasn't right, okay. So that I want to know. Who are you going to tell what is happening? Swarnakant Prabhu, what happened till now? You tell me within 2 minutes. In whole Tattva Sandarbha, what you learned?
Suppose first of all we learned the Mangala Charanam, the meaning of that. Then we started Anuchet learning.
Anuchet.
There are different. There are 10 pramanas. Out of them, we found out that shabda non-defective shabda pramana is the topmost, and is the king. Others are the servant.
Kaha chay? Where you are jumping actually? This point, that point, that point, that point. You are going. Yeah, I am not able to understand what you are saying. So, let us think that I am a very young, new to you, to this knowledge. So how will you explain to that person like this?
No. So in the Mangala Charanam, the first shloka, we were discussing that Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishna.
Okay.
In that particular shloka, we focused more time.
Why we take that?
There we established Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Lord.
Why Jiva Goswami took that as Mangalacharanam?
Why? Yes, to glorify Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
To glorify Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why. That's why he took that sloka. That sloka from where?
This is from Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto.
5th chapter.
5th chapter, 32 verse.
Who is saying that sloka?
This is Karabhajan.
Karabhajan is saying. Give a mic to Tapomai Prabhu. After that continue, what happened? What we learned?
This verse says that Tisha Krishna means Krishna is Gorbanam or Akrishnam. Akrishnam means not Krishna, but his Gorbanam is Gauranga Mahaprabhu, means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
I didn't get what you are saying. Akrishnam means you are saying Gauravarnam.
Gauravarnam. Akrishnam means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
How?
Krishna. And it's two syllables.
No. That is not Akrishnam. Akrishnam means what?
Akrishnam means actually not black.
Not black.
Yes. With another color.
Another color.
Another color is red and white and black are already fast.
Then black, one, yellow.
Yellow. Three colors are fast.
Who is saying like this?
It is only Jiva Goswami firstly says.
Jiva Goswami is saying no. Jiva Goswami,
then Gargamuni says.
Gargamuni
and Karbhajan. Two both are.
Gargamuni or?
Karbhajan.
Karbhajan, yes. Dono milke kya bol rahe hain? What they are saying?
Gargamuni says.
Okay, give to mic next. Yes.
Hare Krishna. Gargamuni said that in Kali Yuga, black is Krishna is arise. So how yellow? There are three colors.
Okay, I will tell. So that Akrishna is the, we proved the Gauravarna, and Krishna Varnam is also, he is telling about the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna, Krishna means the whose name who is having the Krishna, that is Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why he is. So like that we proved that by that sloka, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is glorified. Then what happened after that? Leave that. Next.
Hare Krishna. So after that, we are trying to various theme, that means Shabda Praman versus Pratakhon.
Why Shabda Praman? Enjoyfully we are discussing about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all of sudden, why we went to this Shabda Praman, this Praman, that Praman?
After,
so dry and why we went to there? What is the need of going to there? What happened all of sudden to us? No? You to Shyamananda Gorpu.
So Jiva Goswami wanted to glorify Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he
That is done. Then so after that, what happened? I have only 5 minutes extra for the video. We have reached to till point.
Come. Krishna.
Now that is done. After that. Mangalacharanam, you came to the last Mangalacharanam. Then not preparing. The content should be all the time. These 2 months you should meditate on the Tattva Sandarbha. Yeah. So completely you should meditate on the Tattva Sandarbha, and if you sleep and if you wake up, every time you have to see Tattva Sandarbha. That is my desire actually.
Anumanda Tattvastha, we came to discuss.
Anubandha Chatushtaya, yes, how, where it is defined.
This three kinds of, this first stroka of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Very good. Last stroka of this Mangalacharanam is telling about the Anubandha Chatushtaya.
Yeah.
So what is that? What that means, last stroka of the Mangalacharanam. So first, that means now we are in the first, and anyway we travel to the last stroka. Last stroka is telling about the essence of this book. Whatever book he is going to write, the essence of that book he wrote in the last sloka. So that means that essence is nothing but the writing about four, that means Anubandha Chatushtaya. So what is Anubandha Chatushtaya? That means what are the Anubandha Chatushtayas from that we got?
One is Vishaya.
Vishaya. What is the Vishaya from that?
Vishaya means Krishna.
Krishna. Sasri Krishna. Yes.
And Jiva Goswami wanted to write a book about Lord Krishna. So Jiva Goswami wanted to write the book. So that is the Samanda of Vishaya and the book.
Yes. Good.
Then it comes to Abhidheya.
Abhidheya.
The subject that's application.
Abhidheya is what? Tatpada bhajam. Bhakti is the Abhidheya. Next, Prema. Krishna Prema is a Prayojana. So these are the Anubandha Chatushtaya. He wrote, Jiva Goswami wrote in the Mangalacharanam. Till now he didn't write the book. He wrote only Mangalacharanam. So after writing Mangalacharanam, that means in the Mangalacharanam, he mentioned what he wants to elaborately explain in his book. That means that is nothing but Anubandha Chatushtaya. That part he did. Now he wants to write a book. So while writing a book, so while he wants to explain this Anubandha Chatushtaya very elaborately, so then before going to explain that directly, so he has to establish the means, that means right means of for right means for explaining these four. Without establishing pramana, you cannot establish prameya. So that's the first pramana has to be established. Then after that, online students, so Svikas Prabhu. Then after that, everyone is following or not?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, can you hear me?
Yes.
So Prabhu, can you repeat the last one which you said, the last sentence? I got distracted a little bit.
Okay, last sentence I said, from the last sloka of the Mangalacharana, we came to know Anubandha Chatushtaya. Then after that, what?
So what? So in Anubandha Chatushtaya, the framework was given. That what the book will be about and what is the relationship of the book with the subject, and that framework was told. And then Jiva Goswamiji is
that
saying
framework
that
was you are saying that framework was,
so Anubandha Chatushtaya explained that what is the subject, what is the relationship of the book with the subject, what will be the process taken, and what will be the prayojanam results of it. So that context was set up. And then it was elaborating that how this relationship of vach and vajak will be established. There was an exploration for the pramanas or the evidences.
No. You are saying that only to explore vach and vajaka, we need pramanas. Like that you are saying?
No, Prabhu. So what results we are trying to in this establish, so the all the Chatushtaya a framework which we are talking for, that to elaborate that we needed a concrete evidences.
Yeah, to elaborate all the points.
Yes.
Vishaya, Sambandha, Abhidheya, Prayojana. To elaborate all these, we need pramana. It's not that for one we need pramanas. Elaborate all these, we need pramanas. So okay, and next. Okay, Mahaseva Prabhu.
Prabhuji, from beginning, like Jiva Goswami has quoted Krishna Vardhan Tusha Krishna.
No. Why you are going to starting? From here, you should continue.
So after that, Prabhuji, like this Anubandha Chatushtaya, these four things are there. So these four things we have to like understand. So for that, he's saying how we will understand. So whether we can understand using these 10 pramanas like Pratyaksha, Anuman Pramana, etc. So for that, he is giving example that if we take these examples.
Sentences are very blur, actually. It's not clear, actually. What you are saying is not clear. So now we need pramanas to elaborately explain Anubandha Chatushtaya.
Yes, Prabhu.
Then what? Then next step is what? What he said?
Then which pramana basically we have to take? Whether we have to take these laukik pramana, I mean this this kind of pramana or shabda pramana versus that he is trying to compare. Like whether can we establish these things? See, Sri Krishna is our vishaya, and whether we can establish Sri Krishna and Sri Krishna plus four other three. So whether we can establish this using pratyaksha pramana, etc., or we have to go to shabda pramana. So he wanted to prove which pramana, which is the method we are going to take from here.
But not much clear, but okay, but it is not really clear. So I am, anyone wants to try? Exactly what Jiva Goswami said there. Yes. Who is raising in the wait, online? Who is raising? Subhangi Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. I'll try to explain. So our main task is now to determine Pramana. But for determining Pramana, human beings have four defects. Brahma, yes. Pramada, Vipralipsa and Karanapatva. And also we cannot conceive the objects which are inconceivable beyond material creation. Yes. Whatever is there, we cannot do. So because of these four defects and not able to touch the object which is beyond material creation, all the 10 pramanas of the human beings are first completely defective. For that, we saw an example.
Yes. Wait. So these 10 pramanas, so we are not able to use for the for our purpose. Okay, next.
Then
you have to remember this. Okay, that is a statement. Next.
Then we saw that each one we analyze separately. But before that, we saw, see, we want to cut a tree. We can use blade, axe, whatever we want. But what is the proper way of using? That is what we are going to determine now. We have to do it with what? There are so many instruments available with us, but which is appropriate, we have to check. So each one of the pramana, we were checking accordingly. All the 10 pramanas we were taking and checking accordingly.
Next. Okay, Mataji. So I will ask another one. So who is going to tell? Is anybody raising a hand in the online? Sajdev Prabhu.
Yeah, Prabhuji, we took these 10 pramanas, but we did only the first two pramanas. We tested them and then we found that they are the relationship of king and servant. These pramanas were the servant and the non-defective shabda was the king.
Wait. You are saying 10 pramanas are there. You are going to king. Why you are going to king? First tell me, what is that king?
King is the non-defective shabda pramana. And we have to show that these 10 pramanas are a subset of that king. That means they are servants of that king.
This is the point we want to, because so we made this statement, non-defective shabda is the king, and after that all these 10 pramanas are the servants. So this, we made this statement, and now you have to prove. So for that, first what we did,
pratyaksha pramana ka, we did the examples.
No, for the proving this. So to say non-defective shabda as a king and others as the servant, there is a 6 criteria is there.
Yes, we discussed those 6 criteria one by one.
We will go for the 6 criteria one by one. Wait, Ashtray Gaurang Prabhu.
From here only?
Here only. From here only. Yeah. Continue, yeah.
So, 10 pramana.
6 criteria is there now in front of us. So now we are applying this 6 criteria for which? For case study, what case study we did?
Yeah, by applying 6 criteria, we established that all these 10 are subservient to non-defective sabda.
First, what we did in this? All 10 we didn't do.
We did only sabda. Sorry, pratyaksha and anuman.
Yeah.
And by doing that, we realized that all other 7 are only based on this pratyaksha, anuman and sabda.
Yes.
Non-defective
shabda. Defective shabda.
So defective shabda. It concluded that means all are defective.
Yes. Finally, all are dependent. We cannot say all are, that means they are all dependent on the non-defective shabda. This much we did. So non-defective shabda is the root for all these pramanas of the human being. So now this non-defective shabda is, if you say brahmadi dosha rahitah vachanah, that means brahmadi dosha rahita vachanatmakah shabdah, if you say like this, that means which is free from the 4 defects. If I say that is the definition of the non-defective, if I say like this, is it sufficient? whatever is free from the four defects, that is the non-defective shabda. If I say like this, is it sufficient? No. Why? So, Prabhuji, Akinchan Prabhu.
Yes, I think that it has to have the same kind of qualifications that six categories we explained. No,
it's being... no. We already said that means non-defective shabda is having that six. That's why it is king.
Yeah.
Now so,
Now this Veda should have also the same kind of qualities, no, superior qualities. Not just these four qualities are enough.
No. Here, what I am asking, non-defective shabda is the king.
Yeah.
That is, it doesn't mean that the non-defective shabda is the king we proved.
Yeah.
But what is that non-defective shabda? To say king, you have six criteria.
Yeah.
That is not the point I am asking.
Mm.
What I am asking, what is the definition of non-defective shabda? I am asking the definition. Definition of non-defective shabda. So six criteria is what? Six criteria is to just to establish non-defective shabda as a king and others as servant.
Mm-hmm.
That discussion is over. Now I am asking, what is the definition of non-defective shabda? How do you define this? You're getting the point? How do we define? Ashtray Gaurang Prabhu.
Sarva Desha Kala Vyapti. But only we heard like that before. That truth should be all time, all place, all situation.
So non-defective shabda means whatever I know, that is non-defective shabda. If I say, so that means if I say, please, here you should focus all of you. So non-defective shabda means if I say, which is free from the four defects, that is non-defective shabda. If I say this much, what kind of problem will come? Everyone will say, you will also say, whatever the words I know, those words are free from the four defects. He will also say, my words are free from the four defects. That Tapomai will say, others will say, others. Everyone will say, whatever I know, that is, so that is free from the four defects. That means if you define non-defective shabda means which is free from the four defects, this much only if you give, then everyone will say that whatever I know, that is free from the four defects and it is non-defective shabda, and you take this. You take my words as non-defective. Like that everyone will say. Then what will happen? What? Yeah. Karuna Sindh Prabhu.
It should be alaukika chintya, like the so many definitions we saw. Is it?
Yeah. Okay.
So many upmas we saw that.
So what can be the non-defective shabda is that we are going to discuss. So just if you say, so which is free from four defects. So this definition is not sufficient. Reasons is, if you say like that, which is free from the four defects, who is going to decide that four defects? That means your words are free from the four defects. Who is going to decide? You will say that. So whatever I say, that is free from the four defects. Like that, everyone will say, then what will happen? Then confusion. There is a contract. That means there is a contradiction. Contradiction will be there for everyone. So that's why here Jiva Goswami is saying that this much definition is not sufficient, which is free from the four defects. So you cannot say this much definition. So this is not sufficient definition. So here the two reasons are given. Just as if this is not sufficient definition, because just as if everyone accepts shabda as free from four defects based on their own understanding, then in their difference of opinions there will be difficulty of not being able to decide the right one. You're understanding? Everyone will say that my words are free from the four defects. Then how to decide the right one? Which is right one? How to decide? Because we defined the criteria is what? Which is free from the four defects. Then everyone will say. Thus, that shabda being approachable by pratyaksha, so becomes dependent on other pramanas, and hence it has the difficulty of not being a pramana. First is, there is a difference in opinion. Difference in opinion. Because everyone will say, my words are free from the four defects. That will lead to the difference in opinion. And next, so that means we are not able to decide whose words are free from the defects. And then, if we pratyakshavagamyatvena, so that means if we use another pramana, if we use another pramana to decide the right one, so here x, y, z, that a, b, c, d, like these four people are there. So he is having his own knowledge, and A is saying, my knowledge is free from the four defects, so whole world should take my words. B is also saying, my knowledge is free from the four defects. D is also saying, my knowledge is free from the four defects. So C is also saying, my knowledge is free from the four defects. So like this, everyone is saying their own words are the free from the four defects. Then whom we should finalize? A, B, C, D, four are there. Whom you will take? So how do you decide bona fide? Who is bona fide? He will say, I am bona fide. A will say, I am bona fide. B will say, I am bona fide. Why we have to take Shastra? Shastra point till now didn't come. So everyone is saying, I am bona fide, I am bona fide. Till now Shastra didn't come actually. Only the 10 human beings are there, they have 10 pramanas. And we have non-defective Shabda, that much only. Shastra point you don't bring. So in this situation, so now, so everyone is saying that my words are non-defective, so that's why you have to take my words. So then how to decide? There will be definitely some contradiction. It's not that the four people are giving the only one. Definitely. So four people will mean four different knowledges will be there. Some contradiction definitely will be there. Then how to decide? How to decide whose is a bona fide? If you use any other pramana to decide the knowledge of the A, B, C, D as correct, then what will happen? They are also defective. If you use pratyakshadi pramanas, they are already defective actually. So those you cannot use. Even if you use, what will happen? So what will happen? This knowledge, whatever is we are going to finalize, that is depending on another pramana. So that's why it will not be a nirapeksha, independent. Then it will lose this independence actually. That means, does the Shabda being approached with pratyaksha, so becomes dependent on other pramanas, and hence it has to be difficult of not being a pramana. So since it is depending on others, then how can you say this is the authentic? You cannot say it as authentic. So you cannot take. So now we have this kind of problem. So then how to decide? What is the criteria for the non-defective Shabda? Which can be the non-defective Shabda? What is the criteria? What are the different criteria? That means we should, so that we can accept, everyone will accept. That criteria we are going to see now. Criteria for what? So how to decide? That means non-defective shabda we are seeing. This. First. Tasmad yaha nija nija vidvattayai sarvaihi eva abhyas sarvaihi eva abhyasyate. Point number one, which is accepted by everyone for their own scholarship. First point is what? It should be accepted by. So it is accepted by everyone for their own scholarship. For their own scholarship. Okay, it should be accepted by everyone. First criteria. Second is what? Yasya adhigamane sarveshamapi sarvaiva vidvatta bhavati. That means which on being studied gives all kinds of scholarship to everyone. What? It should give. That non-defective shabda should give all the kinds of scholarship to the everyone. It should be like that. All the scholarship. To everyone. Next. What is the next point? Yat krita yaiva parama vidvat. Pratyakshadikamapi Shuddham Syat. That means it is the one which alone gives supreme scholarship to purify Pratyaksha and other Brahmanas. It purifies, it gives such a scholarship to you so that knowledge purifies Pratyaksha and others. Next is what? Yascha anaditva swayameva siddhaha. It should be self-accomplished. That means it is not dependent on anyone. It is dependent on itself. It should not be dependent on any other one. If it is depending on other one, means it cannot be the supreme. It cannot be the perfect one. Because whomever it is depending, that is taking the full control actually on this. So that's why it should be self-accomplished. And also it should be from beginningless. It should be beginningless. Then only it will be anadi siddha. If it is having beginning, means it is having some source, then it is not self-accomplished. Any object is having beginning is not self-accomplished. For example, this marker is having the beginning. Is it self-accomplished? That means, is it existing by its own? That means this pen, this marker is manufactured by itself? That marker itself manufactured itself? No, someone manufactured this. That means it is having the birth date. It is having some birthday. Whoever is having birthday, he is also having the death day. So that's why it is not self-accomplished. So any object is having beginning, it is not self-accomplished. So to become self-accomplished, it should be beginningless. Next. Saeva nikila aitihya mula rupo mahavakya samudayaha shabdotra grihyate. What is that next point? Fifth point is, which is root for all paramparas and is collection of mahavakyas. That means all the traditional knowledge, it should be the source. It should be source for all the traditions. It should be source for all the traditions. So who is that? So what? Purifies pratyakshadi pramana, pratyaksha and other pramanas. Is there? This is the third point. Sarvasamvadini third point. It is A, B, C, D, E. These are the points only. So who, what kind of text can satisfy this criteria? Like now our physics textbook is there. Can satisfy this? Physics textbook written by someone, some author. That means, first of all, it is accepted by everyone for their own scholarship. All the scholarship to everyone. It should give the all the kinds of scholarship to the everyone. Is it possible for the physics textbook? Is it possible for the maths textbook? Is it possible for the any social textbook? No book. No book made by in our library is having this kind of. And also it should be self-accomplished. It should not be written by some author. It should be self-accomplished. It is beginningless. And it should give all the kinds of knowledge to everyone. If anyone read that, then he should get this some scholarship. And it should purify other pramanas. So what is that? What is that? Who, that means any book, anyone can so bring the their knowledge and match this criteria. Is it possible in this whole world? No. Then that is what? That is sacha shastrameva. So what is that shastram? Veda. That is Veda. Why we are taking Vedas as non-defective shabda? This criteria, because that is fulfilling this criteria. Sacha shastrameva tacha veda eva yayeva anadi siddha sarva karanasya bhagavatah anadi siddham. So now, what is this Vedas? What is the Veda? Now, so the one which fulfills this criteria can be the non-defective shabda. So that is the Veda we said. So now the point is, what is Veda? So Veda means, here it is said, yaha eva anadi siddhaha sarva karanasya bhagavatah anadi siddham punah punah srushtyadau tasmadeva avirbhutam apaurusheyam vakyam. It is the apaurusheyam vakyam. That means no human being made this. Even Supreme Lord also didn't made this. It is eternally. Anything is made means it is having the birthday and it is also having the death day. So that's why no beginning. It is not having any beginning. It is self-accomplished. Anadisiddha. But how it comes? So at the time of creation, so Lord exhale the Vedas. So it is coming. And it is also going inside. Coming and going. So for how long it is happening? It is happening. Since how long it is happening? Time. No beginning. You cannot find any beginning. If you have any beginning, then you can say this is the reason. But there is no beginning, then how? No beginning. Yaiva anadi siddhaha sarva karanasya bhagavatah anadi siddham punah punah srushtyadau tasmadeva avirbhutam. So it is manifested from him, and also it is going back and manifested like this. Tadeva brahmadi rahitam sambhavitam. This is free from four defects. Tacha sarva janakasya tasya cha sadopadeshaya avashyakam mantavyam. So it is exhaled by the Lord. Lord is giving for us when the creation is happening. So he is exhaling that and we are getting this. And if anyone wants to follow the orders of the Lord, he has to study the Vedas and understand what Lord is saying. Tadeva avyabhichari pramanam. This is only the avyabhichari pramanam. That means it always produces the right knowledge towards its prameya. So what about which object it is saying? About that object, it always says in the same way, no change. It produces the always right knowledge. Tadeva brahmadi rahitam. तदेवचा अव्यभिचारी प्रमाण तच्च तत्कृपया कोपि गृह्णन्ति बाय द मर्सी ऑफ द लॉर्ड फ्यू पीपल ओनली टेक दिस एवरीवन विल एक्सेप्ट वेदास नो कोपि कोपि तत्कृपया कोपि गृह्णन्ति सम पीपल दे एक्सेप्ट दिस कुतर्क कर्क समूढाः वा तन्न गृह्णन्तु नाम तेषाम् अप्रमापदं कथम् अपयात् कथम् अपयातु सो नेक्स्ट देन हू इज नॉट गोइंग टू टेक दिस हू आर नॉट गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट दिस कुतर्क कर्क समूढाः हू आर दैट मीन्स हैविंग सो बैड लॉजिक एंड हूज हार्ट इज वेरी या इज ड्राई Karkasha. That means very hard heart. Mudaha. That means foolish people. By the Lord's mercy, some people accept, but people with the crook logic are fools, don't accept Vedas. How does their path of wrong knowledge go away? That means who will remove their ignorance? How they will come out from that wrong path of the knowledge? Okay. So like this, we are saying Vedas are non-defective Shabda. So we are saying that whoever is not taking Vedas, they are Kutarka Karkasha. What is this, Prabhu? You are simply scolding and forcefully you are giving. Like that is happening. So now you have to get so many doubts on this point actually. So who will ask the good doubt, expected doubts? Let's ask doubt. Very important actually. Online also okay. Yes, Nam Sankirtan Prabhu. Yes. Some opponent we want now, actually. This is our time. Who?
Yeah, so when we listed this five criteria,
yeah,
to say that if something is matching this five criteria, then this is Shabda. So, for example, how can we perceive or prove beginningless of something? So you gave example of if someone wrote a book on physics, and if they write that this book on physics is beginningless. So how can we prove that it is beginningless or not beginningless? So what method of acquiring knowledge will we use to understand the beginningless of something?
Yeah, physics book, what I said, it cannot be a non-defective Shabda. The reason is it is not beginningless. It is written by someone. So what is your point, Prabhu, here? So
how can we prove that something is beginningless or something has a beginning? What method will we use to understand if the Vedas are actually beginningless?
yes. So how can we decide one is beginningless? So, but we can easily prove that it is beginning. It is having beginning. Mass physics and physics chemistry are having beginning. That can be easily known actually because it is not.
Someone can also say that Srimad Bhagavatam has a beginning because it was written down by Vyasa.
yeah. So yeah, someone can raise this kind of statement. So this is also your Bhagavatam is also beginning. So is having beginning, is written by someone, then how can you say? So, but I didn't come to till now Bhagavatam. Okay. So let me come to the place of Bhagavatam. Now we are taking Vedas. So Vedas are the beginningless, we are saying. So Vedas are the beginningless and Vedas are the giving all the kinds of the knowledge to all the people. So who is telling about this? Who can tell about the Vedas? Who is proving this? Vedas are the beginningless. Who is proving? Vedas themselves they prove because they are self-accomplished. If you use something pramana to prove Vedas, then that will be the pramana actually. Whoever is proving Vedas, then Vedas will not be self-accomplished. So that's why asking question, Vedas, how can you prove Vedas? His question itself is wrong. Question itself is wrong. Why? We are saying Vedas are self-accomplished. So how Vedas are self-accomplished and how Vedas are anadi, you have to know from the Vedas only. If something is going to prove Vedas, then what is the point of Vedas, accepting Vedas as authority? We should not accept Vedas as authority. And also we came to know, yeah, we are saying here, whoever is not accepting Vedas, they are all kutarka, muda, fools. Jiva Goswami is saying they are all fools. Because, why he is saying fools? Because we already proved all the 10 pramanas of the human being are defective. We already established. Even after establishing that, you are not accepting, you don't have no way actually. So now what has happened? Now the scenario is like this. Now the scenario is like this. So now you are there and you are just encircled by all the directions. Now you have only one direction is open to you. So that means we proved all the 10 pramanas of yours are defective. And we opened only one chance they have actually. What is that? They should accept Vedas. They should accept Vedas. If they don't want to accept Vedas, if they go for the what they will, where they will go then? If they don't accept Vedas, where they will go? If they go to their own 10 pramanas, we already discussed that. Enough. We don't want to discuss that. Is there any option for them? Is there any option is remaining for that person? No. So that's why Vedas. Then how can you say about the Vedas like this, these points, these six criteria? Veda itself is saying. Because Vedas are self-accomplished. You cannot take another's help to prove the Vedas. Then Vedas cannot be self-accomplished. So is there any, can you crack this logic? Is there any possibility? Now completely Jiva Goswami, completely he closed all the doors and he opened only one door for you. That is, you have to accept Vedas. If you don't accept, that means even after discussing this much, if you don't accept Vedas, kutarka karkasha mudaha, then who are going to? So remove their ignorance. They will be always in the path of the wrong knowledge gaining. That means they always accept the means which give the wrong knowledge. Then who will save them? Nobody is going to save them. Yes. You got the point, actually? All of you got? Yeah.
I want to raise 2 points.
Yes.
As a Purva Paksha. One is that we are born in India and we never seen Veda in my life. Nobody, I never seen Veda. Physically, I never seen Veda and even not read, heard only name. So if they are self-dependent, self-accomplished, they're supposed to reach to all the jivas, but they're not reaching us. It's one.
Now your point is Vedas are not fully available. Even being an Indian, so I didn't see, I didn't hear. So how? So that we are going to deal in the next Anucheda.
That was one point.
And that we'll be getting answer for that in the next Anucheda.
My argument was that we talk Vedanta, but nobody outside, at least modern people will say that what is Veda? We never heard or never seen it.
Yeah.
Okay, second word, Veda, now they will say is also written by some human being.
Vedas are written by somebody
wrote.
What is the proof?
It is written that itself is proof. Printed in the press, that printing press name is there.
So Vedas are, but at least you will accept these six criteria. That means non-defective shabda means these six criteria. That means it should be self-accomplished. So now we are saying Vedas, and someone is coming and saying this Vedas are the, so not self-accomplished, and they are also written by the human being. So what is the proof actually? So someone is printed means it is written by someone. No, actually, it's not like that. So Veda Vyas also didn't write Vedas or didn't write Puranas. Just he compiled those and already existing eternally those. Yeah. How can you know all this? Veda itself is saying. So how can you accept, I want another Pramana? If you are accepting another Pramana, then your logic is wrong. Why you are asking others? Others are having no capability in front of the Vedas. What is the value of other Pramanas? Other Pramanas already disproved. How can we know Vedas are self-accomplished? Veda itself is saying. Yes.
Here one point is saying that Vedas, defectless Pramanas.
Yes.
Why I have to believe that?
Why you have to believe that? Because Vedas are saying. No other way. You have no other way. In this whole world, you don't have any other way to get the right knowledge. All already finished. Everything is finished. Your pratyaksha, your anumana, your shabda, your all pramanas are, they are servants of the non-defective shabda.
Then people may say that now I am unable to understand this also, that also. I'll leave everything and then I'll do my job on material services.
So if someone is not able to understand this much sober discussion, Jiva Goswami did very sober discussion till now. Very soberly he explained. Clearly he is giving the proper examples. And he established how the pratyakshadi pramanas of the human being are so imperfect. He clearly explained. Even after explaining also this explanation, sober explanation, still you have faith on those, then who is going to save? Katam apayatu. What he is saying? So he is saying that tesham apramapadam. That means the path which is leading to the ignorance, illusion. Who is going to remove that? They are mudaha. Else, any question? Online, yes. Online. Okay. Yes.
I have two questions.
Yeah.
The first question is, when we were discussing that pratyaksha is a servant of the shabda, we discussed some examples of shabda.
Yes.
Like dasham tomasi and Himalaya. So we took them as a shabda, but they were not vedvakya. So that is one question. So why we took them as a shabda? And we have written so many examples of shabda also, which were not vedvakyas. That is my first question. The second question is, as you said, the shabda is the words, and the shabda pramana, the person hears, he gets the knowledge. That is a shabda pramana, complete. The shabda is there, person heard, he had a knowledge of that, and he gets the knowledge. The problem comes in the Vedas, people interpret in different. The same shabda, people take it different meanings.
That will be coming in the next Spotavada, but we are not able to discuss because that is having more, that means those things all he clarified.
Okay.
People may interpret the Veda into many ways, then they may get the many meanings. So then what is the solution for this? He discussed, but that we are not going to discuss in our classes. But your question is, in our process of establishing other Pramanas as servant, so we took the some statements, so as non-defective. So how can you say? So how can you say? Because you see example, dashamastvamasi. That means in that dashamastvamasi, we took as a non-defective. So of course, it is not from the Veda, but is it, that means, can you show any defect in that? That means now 10 people, no. So that's why what is the problem actually? Can you show any defect then? If you say it is dashamastvamasi, that means 9 people crossed and they are having confusion and they are thinking that they are not counting themselves. And new person came and he said, "You are the 10th one." And he said, "Dashamastvamasi." I took Dashamastvamasi as the non-defective shabda. So if someone is going against to this, and can anyone prove that this is having some defect? Nobody can prove. That's why. Yeah. So next. Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes.
I have like two questions. So first question is, we are saying that we were going to prove that what is non-defective shabda?
We are defining the criteria for the non-defective shabda.
And we have just proposed that Veda is the non-defective shabda.
Yes.
So as a student, now I'm on the crossroad that unless and until I know Veda, it's a proposal that Veda is the non-defective shabda. Unless and until I know Veda, I do not know whether these six criteria are met by Veda.
Yes.
Now, this is my lifetime question.
Yeah.
In a sense.
Yeah.
In a sense.
I understood, Prabhu, your question. Yeah. So Vedas are having these six criteria, that how to know, that means that you'll be knowing in the next Anuchedas.
How to establish that? And second thing, Prabhu, I wanted...
next Anuchedas, we are going to discuss all those. Now, how the Vedas are having six criteria, easily we'll come to know that.
The second thing, Prabhu, I wanted to ask, which is my mind's doubt is, we understand ourselves, and I'm just jumping on this word as an Atman or soul, you know, just if you can assume that I'm jumping on that word that we are. And we also understood a little bit from our background that is self-illumined thing. That is, it doesn't need anything else to be known by it. So why somebody like Jiva cannot explore himself? Because if, you know, like without even reading book, if you like, you know, I don't know if I'm able to tell my question, but what I'm saying is, if we are Jivas, Prabhu,
okay,
or Atman, so Atman is not worldly thing, right, Prabhu? It is beyond, inconceivable in many senses, right? It is timeless. Yes. Why it cannot have its own light to tell about itself? Why somebody required to read a book?
Yes. So Jivatma by itself, it cannot come out from this ignorance, because paropi manute anartham yaya sammohito jivaha paropi manute anartham. So Vasudev, how he realized this Jivatma is bewildered by the Maya. Okay, Jivatma is bewildered with the Maya, and this Jivatma, even of course, is superior to the Maya, but it is bewildered by that Maya, and it is fully in that control. And this Maya is not at all. That means this Jivatma by himself, can it come out from the clutches of the Maya? It cannot. That is not the nature of the Jivatma. No, it needs definitely the help. Daivi hesha gunamayi mama maya duratyaya maya me maya mameva ye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. So whoever is surrendering to me, they only can cross this Maya. Not everyone.
So
that is the Prabhu, nature of the soul.
So Prabhu, the question is, Veda was written by Ved Vyasji.
Break,
so how
started.
Did Prabhu?
Yeah.
Ved Vyasji wrote Veda. Before him, nobody has written Veda. How did he realize?
He didn't write, I'm saying.
No, no, Prabhu, I'm saying, how did he realize about it?
It's compiled, and yes, that he is Lord himself, he is avatar of the Lord. And he gave for us. So by the, this is in the sound form, it is eternally existing, and he received that in the hearts, and he gave. In the few examples will be coming, actually. All these doubts will be cleared one by one. Yes.
Hare Krishna.
Everything will be known by the, whatever we are speaking, that is also written in the Veda only. How do you know that Veda Vyas gave these Vedas to us? Who is going to say? Veda itself is going to say that. Because no other one can say that. Okay, yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, one more common argument we face about Vedas is that it said that Veda being studied gives all kinds of scholarship. Means Veda is supposed to be source of all knowledge.
Yes.
Okay, and all this knowledge, like this laptop, everything we see, these people made this and they are scholar on this subject, but they are not, they didn't study Veda, but they still, they are scholar on all these things. Many people are scholar on making computers and
everything. No, they are not scholar. Whoever is expert in making computers, who are expert in the building buildings, so they are not scholar. So scholarship, how we'll decide, that means who is scholar is, so who knows Brahma janati iti brahmana, so whoever knows the absolute truth, he is a scholar actually.
But previously there was one sentence, laukika alaukika jnana nidanatvam.
Yes, even Vedas can give the knowledge about the objects related to material world and also object related to the spiritual world, both. Yes. Actually, that's why it is not knowledge, actually. Even it is a materially also, if you see, so these are all not considered as knowledge. So whatever we have, this avidya it is. The avidya, that means this mass, physics, chemistry, all this is avidya only. It's not material vidya also. Material vidya means what? It should be actually harmonic with the nature. And you see, whatever this technology, whatever we have, this is not going to harmony, is not going to be harmony with the nature. It is going to create the destruction to the nature. So how can we say this is knowledge? This is actually is not knowledge, it's ignorance. And we are, that's why every day increasing the problems and making the life complex. Okay, thank you very much. A question online, okay. Yes. Sajdev Prabhu. The mute he kept. Okay, leave it.
Yeah, Prabhuji. Hello, Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah, Prabhuji, you said just now that in harmony with the nature.
Yes.
So can you give us an example, one simple example for that?
Example is, now you can make a product from the cow dung.
Yeah.
So this is also science. So you can make your manure for your fields. Okay. So from the cow dung.
Yeah, that's a good answer. Okay.
Yeah. So it is what? It is going harmony with the nature and it is going to nourish the plants. And also it will not disturb the nature.
Yeah.
But instead of using that, you are using some fertilizer, chemical fertilizer.
Yeah.
It's a tamasic actually. It is destruction to the nature. And health also is destroyed and also nature is polluted.
Yeah. So all this will be sattvic, mode of goodness. Okay, Prabhuji.
These are all given by the Vedas.
Yeah.
This is the material knowledge given by the Vedas.
Yeah. But my same question was this, that in that five criteria which we did of Shabda, the word scholarship is used in first, second and third one. It repeats. So what is this scholarship? Is related to
okay. second and third
mein scholarship word aata hai, teeno mein.
Yes, all the scholarship to everyone, that is the second, and next third one is purifies that. Third one purifies the pratyaksha pramanas.
But what scholarship, what is the word scholarship relates to? What, that is the question.
Scholarship relates to the material knowledge and related to material and spiritual both. Vedas, if you practice Vedas, you will be getting the complete knowledge on the material science and also you'll be getting the complete devotional science, that means spiritual science, both. That is a scholarship. That means knowing the objects as it is known as scholarship. So knowing the objects as it is, material and spiritual objects, knowing as it is a scholarship. Yes.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, it's a very common question. So if we say that the Vedas is the Shabda, but the way we interact with the Vedas, so by reading a book, we're also inevitably going to use our senses. So does it mean that Shabda, it will be dependent upon Pratyaksha?
Very good, Prabhu. This is the next class topic.
You know, like, for example, we're hearing...
I understood your question.
Yeah, so,
I understood your question, Prabhu. Shabda is received through the Pratyaksha only. That means senses, ears we use, the senses. So then how? That means this Shabda, so can you accept? That means this is the defect of the Pratyaksha is there. That point we are discussing in the next class. We'll be discussing in the next class, immediate class. Vachaspati Mishra. So in this, Vachaspati Mishra is saying on this. In his Bahamati Tika. Okay? That we'll discuss in the next class. Your voice is not audible. I don't know. It's mute.
Yeah, and just one very quick thing. Yeah. Is it correct to say that the 10 pramanas, which Jiva Goswami is mentioning, he took them from Gautama Rishi, from Nyaya Shastra, Sutras? Or these are 10 pramanas established by Jiva Goswami?
Actually, Nayayikas, they don't accept all 10 pramanas. They accept only Pratyaksha, Anumana, Shabda, and Upamana. That's all. They don't accept other. So Jiva Goswami, definitely he might have referred some other, all the schools maybe he, whatever possible pramanas are there, he might have taken. Yeah.
Okay.
But it is not from the Gautama. Mm. Gautama accept only 4.
Okay. That's clear. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki. Jai.